welcome to learn it. Before I start, I would like to welcome you as you have chosen a good stream as many of you want to pursue in medical field, pharmaceutical, biotechnology industries, etc. Before beginning this topic, I would like you to tell that after viewing this video, don't make any false judgment about the subject biology. These kinds of topics are just a small part of biology, and there is a huge empire to learn which is much more interesting. I also know this is just the starting of many students' career path, so I wish we will stick together for a longer time. So without wasting more time, let's get started. In this video, we will be learning about 11th class biology, chapter 1, diversity in the living organisms. Let's start with the introduction. Wide variety of living things around you. From the potted plant on your desk, to the bird on your window, to the microscopic germs on your hand, the diversity in living organism is truly mind-blowing. So let's get started. Now we'll start from the classification. Now let us discuss what does classification means. It is the arrangement of animals and plants and different organisms on the basis of their similarity and dissimilarity. In other words, we can say that science is the arranging of organisms in series of groups and subgroups on the basis of their similarity and dissimilarity. Aristotle classified organism on the basis of their habitat. Now what does the habitat means? It is the place where they live, like in water, in air, or on land. Now we'll start from the next topic, which is basic characteristics of classification. Now we have already divided many of the classification, and one such classification is the nature of cells. The cells has been divided into two parts, one is prokaryotic and second one is the eukaryotic. As you can see it from the screen, we have already divided it into two parts. On one side you can see the difference between of prokaryote with the diagram, and on the second side you can see the difference between of eukaryotes with the eukaryotic diagrams. Now if you can see it clearly, the first point indicates that in prokaryotes, most prokaryotes are unicellular, which means they are made up of single cell. In eukaryotes, most eukaryotes are multicellular, which means they are made up of one or more kinds of cells or one or more types of cells. The second point for prokaryotes tell us the nucleus is very poorly defined, which means they don't have any kind of nuclear membrane surrounding the nucleus. In eukaryotes, there will be a well-defined surrounded by the nuclear membrane nucleus. Next point is nucleolus is absent. In eukaryotes, nucleolus is present. In prokaryotes, all the cell organelles such as plastids, mitochondria, Golgi bodies, etc. are absent. They are not present in these kind of prokaryotic organisms. And when we are talking about eukaryotes, all the cell organelles such as plastids, mitochondria, Golgi body, etc. are all present in a single cell. When we are moving on to the next topic, which is what are the types of prokaryotes, comes under is bacteria and blue-green algae, which are also called as prokaryotic cells. And when we are talking about eukaryotes, fungi, plant, animal cells are coming under eukaryotic cells, including humans. Humans are also having eukaryotic types of cells. The next characteristics on the basis of classification is cellularity. What do you mean by cellularity? Now, on the cellular level, the cells have been divided into two parts. The one is known as unicellular and second one is known as multicellular. Now, what does the unicellular means? Unicellular organisms are the organism that only have a single cell, which means in case of amoeba, bacteria and paramecium, etc., comes under unicellular organism or single-celled organism. Now when we are moving on to the right side, it is written there multicellular, and all the organism which consist of many cells or different kinds of cells, as in case of plants and animals, comes under multicellular organisms. Now when we are moving on to the next, we come under level of organization, which means when we are talking about a single cell thing, which is known as at a cellular level, and when cell divides, it converts it into tissues, tissues make organs, and organ makes the organ system. This is the level of organization when we are moving from a single cellular to a multicellular. Then this will also act as a basis for creating classification. And the last thing is the mode of nutrition. Mode of nutrition means in which mode he or she or any kind of organism will take his food. It has been divided into two parts. One is autotrophic and second one is heterotrophic. Autotrophic means of its own. If you can prepare, if you can manufacture your own food, just in case of photosynthesis, you comes under autotrophic. Many, approximately 99% of the green plants comes under autotrophic type of nutrition. Second one is heterotrophic. Now what does the heterotrophic means is whenever a organism or any kind of thing is dependent on any other thing for its nutrition perspective, it comes under heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Let's move on to the main topic, which is classification and evolution. Now let us again discuss what is classification. The definition is the arrangement of animals and plant and different organism on the basis of their similarity and dissimilarity comes under classification. The second thing what I have written is evolution. Now what does the evolution means is it is the change in the characteristics of a species over several generations. Now time is a key factor, which means with the coming time the complexity of the organism changes from simple one to a complex one. So time plays a major role in classification and in evolution also. Now the Charles Darwin, the great scientist, gave the idea of evolution in 1859 in his famous book called The Origin of Species. Those organisms which have ancient body, which means which have a very old body design and not change much, are called primitive organism, which means the old body design of organism which have no changed are called primitive organisms. Those who acquire certain special characteristics during the time period, which means which shows some complexity, some changes in their body design, they are called as advanced or higher organisms. Next topic is biodiversity. Biodiversity is a term used for the various forms of life found in a given area, which means at a particular place, the different categories or different life forms. For example, in a given area, there can be different types of microorganisms, different kinds of fishes, different types of animals and organisms, living and non-living thing, all living in a certain area, which is called as biodiversity. For example, in a temperate area, polar bears are not present, which means the polar bear is not the part of that diversity. Next is, these life forms depend on each other and on the environment and result in a stable community, which means all the organisms meet each other, lives with each other in a harmony, depends on each other and forms a stable community so that all of the biodiversity can work well. Next is, human also is the part of biodiversity. Human have a major role in making this biodiversity a great biodiversity. It is estimated that about 1 crore species on the planet, we only know 20 lakh species, which means we only know 10-20% of the knowledge we have about the species, and approximately 80% of species we don't have any clue till now. The next topic comes under hierarchy of classification. Now what does the hierarchy means is it is to arrange certain thing in certain order or in rank. For example, let us take a school. In school, there will be different departments of different names. Each department will have different subject and each subject will have different kinds of teacher. Let us get it simple again. Let us talk about the classes. When we are talking about classes, the first thing comes under in which school. When we are going into the school, we talk about which class. So say there are different kinds of categories in the class. Now when we are talking about any of the individual class, they will be having different kinds of sections. And in that section, you will be having different roll number for individual students, which will make it appear individual from the other students. Next is, there are different names of the scientists like Ernst Haeckel, Robert Whittaker and Carl Wuss. They have tried to classify the living organism into different kinds of categories, in which R. Whittaker, which is also known as Robert Whittaker, proposed five kingdom classification, which is widely used till now. This kingdom includes five kinds of things. The first is Monera, second is Protista, third one is Fungi, fourth is Plantae, and fifth one is Animalia. And all the organism comes under this category only. Carl Wuss also divided the Monera section, which is also known as kingdom, into two parts. One is Archibacteria and second one is Eubacteria. Here it is the further classification so that we can understand what and how does the classification works. As we all know that R. Whittaker, which is also known as Robert Whittaker, has given these kind of classification, which is known as five kingdom classification, and he had divided the organisms into five parts. In the bottom section, I have written five of the points in the name of kingdom. The first kingdom is Kingdom Monera, second is Protista, third is Fungi, fourth is Plantae, and fifth is Animalia. Now, all these sections are called as kingdom. And when we are looking on the above section where it is written, further classification is done by naming the subgroups at various levels as given, which means after kingdom, for example, let us take Monera. Monera will be the kingdom, and Monera will have the first subcategory, which is known as phylum. Then it will be having class, then it will be having order, family, genus, species, and so on. And for same, Protista will be the kingdom. Protista will also have phylum, class, order, family, genus, species, and so on. And for the same is Fungi also, Plantae also, and Animalia also. That's all for today's video. I hope you understood the thing taught today. For any kind of questions or doubt, you can comment down below. I'll get to your point for sure. For better understanding, I urge you to repeat the video again so that your point can be clear as water. For more of such video, stay tuned to the channel and please do learn it.